Welcome to Upper 90 Studios Podcast. Today we're going to be talking about the new players for Manchester United, Man City, Liverpool that are going to be here at the Guinness International Champions Cup this summer in America. And we're going to two games, Manchester City against Liverpool at Yankee Stadium July 30th at 7 p.m. Then we travel to Michigan for Manchester United against Real Madrid at 4 p.m. And that's at University of Michigan Stadium, which holds, I think, 110,000 people. That's going to be insane. But today, I want to talk about all the new players that we're going to get a chance to see before the English media, and I love that. We Americans get first dibs on seeing these players in action before the English media. So let's start with Manchester United. They brought in Ander Herrera, who is a 24-year-old Spanish midfielder, played for Athletic Bilbao. He can run, he can dribble, he's got great technical ability, he's 6 foot. He's a well-rounded midfielder. I think he'll fit in perfectly at Manchester United, especially because he already has some history with some of the players. He played at the U21 Euro Championships with Spain. De Gea, Juan Mata, and Herrera on the team and out there at the same club. It's going to be interesting because Manchester United has a bunch of number 10s, I feel, already on the team. They have Rooney, who thinks he's a number 10, even though I don't think he is. He's a center forward. But he thinks he's Paul Scholes for some reason. Then we have Kagawa, who I think is an incredible player. And because he was so good at passing last season, Moyes hated high-quality football, so he benched him. And then you have Juan Mata, who is obviously Mourinho can't stand. Anyway, Juan Mata, Kagawa, and Rooney, all number 10s. It's going to be interesting to see where Herrera fits. I think he's going to be playing a little bit deeper than those players, similar to where Carrick plays, except he's young. He's 24, so he's able to get up and down the pitch without a problem, whereas Carrick can only get up the... Well, he never made it past the halfway line last season because he's... Anyway, let me give you a couple of stats about Herrera last season in particular. He completed more through balls than Carrick, Rooney, Kagawa, Fletcher, Cleverley, and Fellaini combined. In La Liga, only Fabregas attempted more through balls than Herrera. He had more assists than Kagawa, Fellaini, and Young combined. That's crazy. And he had more tackles than Carrick and Fellaini combined. They've addressed the center midfield position now. They still need someone else, somebody like Vidal from Juventus, which there are rumors that they're after. If they get him, then with Louis van Gaal at the helm, I think it's going to be... They're going to be back in the top four at least. But... Also at the back, left back position, it was a big problem last season for Manchester United because they had a player in Evra who was misused, again, playing 3 games a week by Moyes. And his replacement was Alexander Butner, who was Moyes' favorite defender for some reason, instead of Fabio Da Silva, who was an absolute shock the way Moyes treated this kid. How many important goals did Butner cost Manchester United last season for not knowing how to play a simple offside? Just keep your eye on your center backs, on your captain, Rio Ferdinand. Well, granted, he is not the fastest anymore anyway. But the fullback should never be caught deeper than your center back. And this is what... And Butner was playing with blinders on. A sheep could play offside better than Alex Butner, I feel. Louis van Gaal comes in. Who's the first player he gets rid of? Alexander Butner. Van Gaal sent him packing to Russia, literally to Dynamo Moscow. And the good thing is that they also extended Patrice Evra's contract for another year, which means that now you have this kid who's going to be learning from a captain, and so they're shoring up at the back, they're tightening up in the middle, so it's going to be really good for Manchester United. We have a chance to watch these players here, and we're going to give you all the analysis of how they play, because we're going to be there in person. Let's talk about Liverpool. Obviously, the biggest talking point is Suarez. He's going to be irreplaceable. For me, he's easily the third best player in the world right now, behind Messi and Ronaldo. There's just no way to replace someone like that. Barcelona has all but signed him already. The good news is Liverpool is going to have £70 million to splurge on new players because that's Suarez's buyout clause, and Barcelona is going to meet that. So we may see players like Alexis Sanchez coming from Barcelona in exchange, and he was brilliant in the World Cup for Chile. And also, if they get this kid, Markovic from Benfica, I've been watching Markovic last season, 20 years old, and I watched him the same way when Di Maria was there at Benfica, and I thought Di Maria was going to be a great player. He ended up going to Real Madrid. Markovic, I predict, is going to be a better player. He's an attacking central midfielder who will drive straight at the central defenders. With pace and technical ability, that's a nightmare for defenders. Also, the other thing is Daniel Sturridge, who I thought came in, and when he was asked to do a job last season when Suarez was suspended at the beginning of the season, he came in and scored some goals. The guy is ready to take on the mantle as the center forward striker for Liverpool, and Liverpool didn't struggle without Suarez last season. Sturridge, you have Sterling who can come in and do his job, do a part, so it's not all that bad. Brendan Rodgers is slowly building a deeper squad now with Lallana from Southampton. What's so cool about the Guinness International Champions Cup this year is what's really interesting is that Spain, Portugal, Ivory Coast, England, all these teams got dumped out of the World Cup early. So what does this mean for us? It means that all the biggest stars are going to be here for the summer friendlies. Yaya Toure, David Silva, Juan Mata, Cristiano Ronaldo, Wayne Rooney, Gareth Bale. That's crazy. We're going to be there, pitch side, Upper 90 Studios. We're going to be snapping photos, bringing you all the action, interviews, behind-the-scenes stuff that you're not going to get anywhere else, not from the British media. You're going to get it from we Americans are going to give it to you. We have first dibs on these new players. Soccer's popularity is absolutely on the rise in the U.S. There's no mistake in it. We even have a soccer ball car. You can check it out. Soccerballcar.com. We have a Facebook page. I'm not making this up. It's a real VW Beetle dressed like a soccer ball. And we go around. We have a great time just growing the popularity of the sport because the fans are here. The interest is here. We are ready. The country is... The soccer in the U.S., it's like a rocket ship on the launch pad. Everyone's coming here for the preseason tour in the summer. All the bigger teams, even bigger teams, are going to be coming here because the numbers are shooting through the roof. The Real Madrid versus Manchester United game in Michigan was sold out in 24 hours. All the records in the World Cup are being smashed. All the TV ratings records are being smashed. And there's a reason why Manchester City is investing in teams like the New York City FC. And there's a reason why the Yankees themselves are part owners and are investing in soccer, because it's obviously there's an incredible growth potential for it here. So we actually have an infographic and a blog article on our website, upper90studios.com/blog. You can download the infographic and share it, use it however you'd like, put it on Facebook, put it on your website. That's the interesting thing, is that these players are going to be here because some of those bigger teams got knocked out of the World Cup. And Louis van Gaal already said that he's coming here no matter, even if Netherlands wins the World Cup, he'll be here in the U.S. with the team, leading them and training them. He's not going to miss a single match. And he's already told the English and the Spanish players, Manchester United players, to report the training in the U.S. tour. So that includes Rooney, Mata, Herrera. Even Van Persie may miss like the first game, but I think he's going to be there for the second game, and I think he's going to start for the Real Madrid game. So we can't wait. If you need more info, go to internationalchampionscup.com. You can buy tickets, Ticketmaster, or you can go to our website, upper90studios.com, and even don't forget to check out soccerballcar.com. I'm not making that up. It's a real thing. It's going to take over the U.S. See you later.